Hey, baby, and welcome back, everybody. Welcome back here to the Resident Rise 3 server, where we are getting stuff done. And guys, check out what I did to my base. Dun, 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 dun. Hold on, why did I get a little bit of lag there? That should have gone very smoothly. Let's try that again. Dun, 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 dun. So take a look at this, guys. I was messing around with some of these blocks, and I made up my base to be a little more interesting. Let's check it out. We'll get into hover mode here. These little blinky blocks are not ME controllers. They are actually Futura blocks. And what the heck am I? I'm getting chicken. Chicken just flew out of there. Is there a chicken in here? There are dodos in here. Oh my God. That's so funny. I was like, why am I getting, I'm getting eggs and feathers and stuff, and it's these dang dodo eggs. Stupid dodo eggs, take that. So I guess Monkey Puzzle dropped by some dodos. Holy crap, I did not know these were up here. But these guys are pretty darn cute. I wonder if this is a guy or a girl dodo. I guess they're like everything in Minecraft and they don't have a sex, really. But I got two little baby dodos up here. They can run the nerve center here at the top of my menacing tower. Basically, as I was trying to show you from the outside, the menacing tower is made out of all factory blocks and scaffolding blocks. I wanted to give it a real menacing industrial look to go with the theme of this playthrough, which is destroying stuff and polluting the world. So yeah, I decided something like this, and I thought that this little neon accoutrement here, I'm still getting stuff through the wall, would definitely increase the look of the base, especially from afar. I went ahead and I made this smokestack too, and I have no reason why. I just did. And yeah, this is a smokestack. There is absolutely nothing in it. Just a couple of these, what do you call these? These are smoker blocks from Railcraft. And yeah, so I put a little few more smokers up here. I really like the look of this stuff here, this Futura block with the glowing screen with metallic borders, just because of the animation that's involved. This is kind of like the matrix, the brain of the building. And if we go down a floor, I don't think anything is here except for these chicken stuff, or I mean dodo stuff. So there's that, this is an empty room. And if we go down here, another empty room. And here is where we were doing our item collection for the quarry. So the quarry is finished. I got all this stuff. All these chests are filled with goodies. I don't honestly know what to do with all of it, to be perfectly honest with you all, even though I said honest like five times there. But let's go take a look at the world hole. And I thought I could get there a little faster. Hold on. Sometimes if you sprint and then fly, you go a little faster. Yeah, that definitely seems faster. If it would load in, that would be ideal. Come on. Come on, world, load in for me. There we go. Very good. And as you can see, I've got a big dang hole here. And this is where I want to build my base. Basically, it's going to look like I've destroyed the world just to build my industrial complex. I like that I've also done it inside of this pink biome. I think that only adds to it. And now all I've got to do is really kind of empty out some of this stuff here. And what I've been doing, I don't know if I can do it with water, but what I've been doing with to empty out like the water and the lava is I've been using this thing here. This is called, hold on, we'll go to E. This is called an extrapolated bucket from Batania. Basically any item that you bucket up into this bucket will be destroyed. So you can go like this and clean up water. You got to do water pretty quick though, because you know water creates additional water source blocks. So if you just hold down on the right button, you can usually get it all pretty quickly. And yeah, so I've been cleaning this out. I want it completely void of liquids. I think I got all the water source blocks. There we go. And it's going to take a while to update all that. But you can do the same thing with these lava blocks, but the lava blocks, of course, are a bit more dangerous because of these little chumps here. These noisy jerks right there. We're gonna leave them alone. I'll come back for them. I wonder what would happen if I poured water on them. I wonder if that would kill them. I'm not sure. We might have to test that. I don't have a... Oh, I do have a bucket of water. But honestly, I don't have any way to pour it on the guys. Huh. I wish I could test this. Can I pour it right on their head? No. No. Never mind. Hold on. Let's get out of fire here. You could just go right through the thing here. Hold on. Here's some right here. Let's give this a try. I'm gonna pour water on top of these chumps' heads. That definitely hurts them, but not enough to, like, kill them. So they don't like water. What a surprise. But I've just made more of a mess for myself to clean up. Really. There they go. So, yeah, if you want to kill some lava monsters, use water. That makes sense, right? There we go. Get ourselves off fire here. So, we finally got this done. And the bad news is about this quarry is we did not find any draconium. So we added draconium later in the pack, and I was hoping that it would, you know, retrodrin the ores into the overworld, but I found none. And I think it's supposed to appear with a frequency of one per chunk. And this is a lot of damn chunks. This is a lot of damn chunks. I assumed I would at least get one, but that is not the case. I'm just trying to update these lighting glitches here so that they're not all ugly and crap. Get out of my life, lighting glitch. Very good. Okay. So, yeah, got a world hole, check. Gonna build a base here, double check. So I think what I need to do is start getting into some automation of the same building blocks that I used to build this tower over here. And then we're gonna build something horrendous and awesome looking here. It's just gonna be obscenely big, and we're probably gonna use our turtle to build the shell of it. And then we'll come back and pretty it up with various blocks and doodads. So yeah, all right, so that's now talked about. Ah, I love that. If you drop in with your vibrant jetpack, if you suddenly are about to take a lot of fall damage, it will turn into hover mode automatically, and you will be saved from dying. So anyway, just wanted to tell you guys that. So over here, if you guys remember, this is where I was collecting dungeon loot using, I think it's this guy right here, the floating lunium. And the way we were doing that, this chest is full. Is this chest full? This chest has a few things in it, so I need to pick up this advanced item collector, and we'll switch it over to the other chest here, and we'll give it a radius of, I don't know, 4, 5, 5, 5, 4, 6, whatever. And we'll throw this guy down, and yeah, we've been getting a lot of stuff by exposing this lunium to the mana source blocks over here. Almost too much stuff, and honestly, I don't know what to do with it all. There's some of it. I got another piece of dark steel, which, as you know, is dungeon loot, so we can throw that in the chest. Lots of weird stuff. I've got a Count the Times, See the Zephyr, 387. Now, I don't know if you can actually open these books. Oh, you can't open these books. So anyway, there's a book with some garbage in it. Very good. Garbage book. Thank you. And we've got lots of other stuff. We've got a lot of these computer programs, which, honestly, I'm probably just going to throw away. We got a lot of these damaged circuits from the calculator mod, which I want to check out pretty soon. There's something here called a Diamond Zane from a mod I've never even heard of called Z-Tones. Now, I think this is kind of like a Paxel, where you can dig with it, and you can mine with it. And I haven't checked out wood, but yeah, you can use it as an axe too. So it's an all-purpose tool. I wonder if I can... I can't hoe with it, so that is the only downside to the Zane. But I got two of them for free, so that's kind of neat. I've got a lot of Chocopedias. I don't think I need them, but I got them. Every once in a while, I get something called like a pristine zombie figurine. Now, this is from the archaeology mod. If you look here, this is a pristine skeleton figurine. And if I put this guy down, I've now got a little pristine zombie figurine, so that's really neat. I found a few more of them in a dungeon or in some sort of building, but they are damaged. So, oh, this is a pristine Steve figurine. Which one? Let's look at that one. I didn't think to put a lot of these down. I just grabbed them. Here's a broken zombie pristine Enderman figurine. So that's kind of cool. It's like collect the whole bunch. So let's see there. There's the Enderman figurine. Where did the Steve figurine go? There he is. Boop. And there's our, I guess what we could do is we could make like a little shelf to put these guys on. They're very cute. I do like them, but I'm not sure what they do other than look amazing. This one looks the best, I think. The Enderman is like, they could have at least made the eyes the same. I don't know. But I guess that it's supposed to be a totem of some sort. I don't know if it's useful for anything, but there you go. What other goodies did we get in here? We got a lot of these white stones. I'm not sure what they do either. There's something here called a clay pattern from garden containers. This stamp is obscured by dirt. Wash it in a cauldron. Do we want to do that? Let's check this out. I don't know what this is, but it's worth a looky-loo. Excuse me, I'm all flimmy at the moment. Very flimmy. All right, let's make a cauldron. All right, and I'm imagining you put the cauldron down, you fill it with water, and then... Oh, I got a stamp. What did I get there? I got a clay pattern stamp of Savannah. Now, I'm imagining I can put these on here. No? Maybe I need to... Let's pick this up. My inventory's full. My inventory's full of garbage! Alright, get out of there. It's these damn dodos. They've filled my garbage full of inventory. Or something like that. Alright, let's try crafting them together. So if I do that and that, do I get anything? Wait, I think I saw something there. No? Alright, I don't know what the heck to do to these. My guess is I need to put them on a pot of some sort, but I would imagine it would be one of these pots. Because they're both from garden containers. Anyway, let's pull up stamp. Let's do that to it. Okay, that did nothing. If we left click on it, right click on it. So they do something. I just have no idea what. So we're going to put those away until we figure out what they do. It's very much not obvious. You think you could just stamp it on the side of a clay pot. Or you could craft it with a clay pot and make something. But if you guys know, let me know. I don't know. Shoot. So let's pick this up, boom! And let's get back to business, shall we? Enough goofing around with dungeon loot and whatnot. We need to get busy increasing our infrastructure here at Cat Dog Industries. I figure that's what we're gonna call it, this evil empire that we are about to create. Cat Dog Industries needs to continue onward in progression. We need to build, we need to mine, we need to do all this stuff. And if we go to our list, one of the things on the list is, of course, it would be great if we could get diamond seeds, and it would be great if we could get platinum seeds. So I've been working towards that. I've been combining all of this essence, and now I have an absolute ton of the stuff from mining. So I made a bunch of extreme essence. So that, I think, is what we're going to need to make diamond seeds and platinum seeds. So let's grab the stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4 of those, and let's go over here and we'll grab some platinum. It's shiny ingots, but I'm pretty sure that they will work. We'll find out the hard way. And if we grab a few seeds out of this guy, I think we can get this going. I would love to have diamond seeds. I would love to have platinum seeds. These are hard to get items, so I think it's a good idea. Even though it may feel a little cheaty, we're all about cheaty. We don't care anymore. There we go. 2 diamond seeds. Very good. We can plant those right there and right there. And I think if we just repeat the same pattern again with the shiny ingots, we will get platinum. Yeah, baby. Oh, you only get 1 platinum seed. Wow. Okay. That's good. We don't want it to be too easy. So there we go. There's our platinum seed. And there are our diamond seeds. We might actually get ourselves a few more platinum seeds. It shouldn't be too big of an issue. But another seed I made in between episodes are these seeds right here. These are creeper soul seeds. I was mainly getting those for gunpowder, but you can do other things with them as well. One of the things that I'm going to need here very shortly is this item. So if you put it in a 4 pattern, you get yourself a creeper head. So I need a creeper head, so I did that. Let's see here. Do I have any empty chests? Nah, we'll just put it back in this thing. Nope, that's the wrong thing. Give me that. Doop. All right. So I need a creeper head. Really bad. All right, we're going to check these off of our list. We're going to skip these 2. We're going to save fighting the wither for another episode. Now, what I've been trying to do since last episode was make this trans-dimensional... It's not trans-dimensional. It's the dimensional transceiver. My dyslexia has gotten hold of me again. So let's see here. Dimensional transceiver is this guy. You need an ender resonator. An ender resonator is made like this in your slice and splice. And then you need this other thing. Now, I thought that was going to be the hard bit, was the ender resonator. But it turns out the hard thing is this guy right here, the ender crystal. Now, to make an ender crystal, you have to combine a soul vial with a vibrant crystal, but the soul vial needs to have an Enderman in it, and then you get back your Ender crystal. So really interesting stuff, but to make a soul binder is even harder. So let's take a look at that soul binder. It's this guy here. You need a bunch of heads. That's exactly why we made the creeper head. You need a skeleton head, you need a zombie head, you need all the heads. So I went ahead and I got the heads, you know what I'm saying? Know what I mean, Vern? So let's put these together real quick. Boom, we got our soul binder. And what we can do with that is we could stick it upstairs. Oops, I went a little too far. There we go. We'll put it right next to the slice and splice, and it will start charging up. But another thing we're gonna need is that Enderman in a soul vial. So I've never made a soul vial before, but it seems pretty cut and dry. I think you just need 3 pieces of fused quartz. And what else do you need? You need some solarium. And I think that's it. And you make a little bottle out of it that way. So if I remember correctly, it was like this and then like that. And there's your soul vial. Cool. So these are pretty cool. These are kind of like, what do you call them? They're kind of like safari nets in Mine Factory Reloaded, but you can use them to capture things and then combine them, blah, blah, blah. Okay. So I'm gonna grab a bunch of this ender ore. I'm gonna grab this and this, and we're gonna go down into the depths a bit, and we're gonna spawn ourselves an enderman using this ender ore from Artifice. This ender ore from Artifice is actually pretty darn handy, especially when you need an enderman. So for sure, we're gonna do that, and we're gonna use our floating Viniculotus to keep the Enderman nearby so we can keep them in the soul vial. And it looks like it's been eaten through this mana pretty good. Very good. So let's get it started. There we go. There's some Enderman. And if I click him with the bottle, I got him. Oh, I pissed that guy off. Hey, hey, no, you can't have my autograph. Jerk. Anyway, we got our Enderman in the soul vial. Next thing we need to do is make a vibrant crystal, which I think is an emerald surrounded by thingies. So emerald surrounded by vibrant alloy nuggets will get you the magical crystal from heaven. Let's see here, there it is. Ah, what a beaut. So hopefully this doesn't take long, but if it does, and I think we're gonna need 2 of these. Yeah, we're gonna need 2 of these in order to make enough. Oh, it also takes player experience. Well, how do I give it player experience? Use player experience. There we go. So it took experience from me, I guess. Interesting. I guess I could put one of those obelisks next to it and it could use that experience instead. But there we go. We got our soul vial back. We got that. Now I guess we need another one too. Yeah, we're gonna need at least 2 of these. So let's make one again. I'm gonna capture another one of these guys, and when we have another Ender Crystal, I'll be right back. Okay guys, we are back, and I put my crystal there, I put my Enderman there, I tell it to take my experience, and it makes the thing. Very cool. And ooh, look at that, it gives off a weirdo particle effect. I actually like that, that's really cool looking. It's like it's stinking up the place. I like it. Alright, so we got that back, there we go. We're gonna have to keep this soul vial somewhere special, so that we don't lose it. And what else did we need? We needed our 2 Enderman heads, or our 2 Ender Resonators. And what was the trans-dimensional hoo-ha? Trans-dimensional... No, I keep typing in trans-dimensional. It's just dimensional. What's wrong with me? So we click that. We're gonna need 2 fused quartz, so we're gonna need 4 fused quartz. We're gonna need an 8 electrical steel. So let's hope that we have that much. I think we do. And here's our electrical steel. Do we need anything else? Is really that it? After doing all that, I have to ask, is that it? That is definitely not it. All right, so boom. Da, da, da. Those go there. Those go there. What goes on the bottom? Oh, it takes an octatic capacitor. I have 2 of those, perfect, ha-ha! I knew what I was doing the whole time. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Perfect, we did it. Huzzah! 2 dimensional transceivers. Now with this guy, I can run my quarry wherever I want now and not have to worry about bringing tons and tons of power to it. So out here, you guys may remember, I've been using this tower of power to charge up this very large capacitor bank setup that could hold around 225 million RF. Now, this isn't how we're going to generate all our power. This is just how I'm doing it right now. So, what would be cool is eventually get this tree farm going and get a good source of charcoal constantly being produced, and we could feed that into here as well. Eventually, I would like to make a big reactor, mainly because I've never made one before, and that could be feeding into a giant capacitor bank as well, too. And yeah, so cool stuff. What I could do is I think I could stick this one right on top of there, and it's got power, and it's got send and receive power, local buffer. So you can use these items here on the side to either filter what goes in and out of it. You can set up a power system. So if I want to call this one, we're going to call it CatDog1. CatDog1, and we add it to it. And this will be the power. And if I want to send CatDog1, yeah, CatDog1 is going to send power. It's not going to receive it. So very cool. And on the other end, I think I would just set up another one to receive. Now we can give this a try if we wanted to. I think what I might do is try setting an ender quarry, specifically the ender quarry I have way over here. Let's go grab it real quick. And what I want to do is maybe set this up in the nether. Now, I hope that's going to be fine. I don't see there being any problems with it, but who knows? Things are funky sometimes. We're going to leave off the world hole upgrade when we do it in the nether because I don't want like lava spilling everywhere. But I tell you what, we're going to pause the video. I'm going to collect these landmarks. I'm going to go into the nether and we'll set this bad boy up and see what happens. We're just going to use a very small portion of the nether. But yeah, we'll be right back, guys. Hey dudes, we are back and we are in the nether. I forgot to tell you guys, Monkey Puzzle went ahead and reset the nether so that the nether ores could regrow again. We were having problems getting cobalt and ardite ore. We no longer have that issue. So he reset the nether and that's why things look a little different in here. So I went ahead and as soon as I got into the nether, I basically drilled all the way up and came out in a lake of fire, almost died. I lost like 4 hearts and then basically created a way down so that we could easily get out into the nether. And honestly, it's weird how the nether forms. This is supposed to be the same seed, but it looks completely different. And there is also a nether fortress like right here. So that is super cool. We've got easy access to a nether fortress. Not that we terribly need that, but we do. So the real reason I want to mine the nether is because in the nether, I was able to find 1 draconium ore. So that means that in this nether, there is draconium ore to be had. So I'm gonna go right here and I'm gonna drill right up. Shall we? Let's give this a try. If I can just, actually, let's just drill a hole like this. This will be quicker, I think. We're gonna set up our quarry up here. We're gonna do a real small one to start with. But I want to be able to, we'll just do it right here. It appears to be meat up here, which is bothering me. Maybe we go down just a little bit. All right, that's good. Let's get in here. Come on. Come on, Papa. There we go. Okay. So if we turn off that and then we pull out the big mamma jamma, we can get started on a proper quarry. Very good. So we'll throw our, let's go ahead and get our landmarks out. Like this, and we'll just drill along this way a little bit, hoping that we don't hit any lava pockets. Very good, that seems good to me. And if we do the same thing this way, we can get the landmark set this way. It's like I can't go far enough. There we go. All right, so one right there. Go all the way back here, one right there, and then you right there. Very good. All right, so we got our landmark set up. If we wanted to clear out a little more space for ourselves, no problemo. Very good. All right, so quarry down, ender chest on top of it, transdimensional transceiver right there, and we'll put the Silk Touch upgrade on here for good measure. All right, analyzing, it has found. So why isn't this, here we go, cat dog one, receive. Now, will that work? It's working. Now, is this quarrying? Oh, it is quarrying. So it is collecting netherrack, very slowly, mind you, and it's putting it in those chests down at my base. So what we need to do is, I'm gonna pause it right here and I'm gonna go back to base and make room for all the goodies we are about to get from, you can see the dirt has already started. The dirt is being made, it's very good. All right, let's throw this in here. This is just a test to see what we can get, and I'll meet you guys back at the base. Okay guys, we are back at our quarry collection base thing here, and it has filled this much up with netherrack, and then it got completely full up. These chests are already full from the first quarry, so I went ahead and I made myself two more diamond chests, and I want to see how full this is getting. It's almost completely full. Now, what I ideally want out of this the most is just draconium dust. So as much as these nether ores are cool and all, I don't care about them, to be perfectly honest with you. So I'm gonna make it so that it vents out the netherrack and also the flesh. So I'm gonna go here to this guy. We can take basalt and that stuff off there. We can throw flesh in there and we can throw that in there. And I think that'll start emptying this out. And then what we can do is put these two chests right here and they will start filling up with everything else, right? Oh, I think we got to set the output. All right, first we got to drill a hole in the floor and then turn on hover and go down just a little bit. Clicky, insert, and then that should get them all set up for collection. Anything good yet? I don't know if it's doing it. I think it's busy trying to do this other stuff. I wonder if I even clicked that. No, it looks like I clicked it. It should be putting stuff in here. There we go, there's the stuff. So I guess we'll just have to sit and watch this to see if any draconium ore stumbles into here. Other things that would be good to get, of course, is nether quartz. It would be great to get some glowstone and maybe even like one of those heat stones from, what is the mod called? I think it's Railcraft. But yeah, cool. So we've definitely started mining the nether for all of its fabulous resources, and we've got an automated way to get our power there. So very cool. I am pleased with our progress today, and I say that is it. So guys, as always, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, let me know in the comments. Leave me a big thumbs up, all that good stuff. And if you have any questions, let me know. See you guys. Bye.